While England Slept is only one of dozens of books authored by Sir Winston Churchill, Britain's World War II Prime Minister. Churchill died 45 years ago today, which to some may seem like a very long time, but which is actually only half the length of his remarkable life.
I have nothing to offer but blood, toil, tears, and sweat.
He was a towering figure of the 20th century.
Lift up your heart. All will come right. Out of the depths of sorrow and of sacrifice will be born again the glory of mankind.
Few men have changed the course of history as Winston Churchill did, and few have done it with such eloquence.
We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender.
He had a passion for words.
What kind of a people do they think we are?
And for those looking to explore that passion, there's a small bookshop in New York City that specializes in Churchill's work.
Were you a big Churchill buff? Is that how you happened to have a store?
No, actually, I was not.
Barry Singer opened the shop in 1983.
The idea to name the store Chartwell and to have it here was actually the idea of the man who built this building.
Tucked neatly into the lobby of a Park Avenue skyscraper, Chartwell, named after Churchill's home in Kent, England, sells rare pieces of his work and nearly everything written about him.
There are 44 books by Winston Churchill, which include all the speech compilations. So he wrote probably more than any political figure ever has. And there's probably more about him, except perhaps Napoleon.
Chartwell carried only a handful of Churchill books until wealthy bankers in the building began asking for his writings.
A corporate raider of the 80s named Saul Steinberg, who was quite legendary in his day, his secretary called down and she said, "Mr. Steinberg will take those books. Would you please get him everything Churchill wrote in first edition and have it bound in leather?" And I said, "Would you like an estimate of what that might run and how long it might take?" And she said, "No, just do it as soon as possible." This gave me the dispensation to go to England and to begin to buy books on Churchill in earnest. I built a beautiful collection for him, but I also discovered while I was there that although every bookstore in the country seemed to have a shelf on Churchill, no bookstore specialized in Churchill, oddly enough. So I found my niche.
Through the years, other figures with their own place in history have turned to the shop for Churchill's work. British Prime Minister Gordon Brown gave a biography from Chartwell to President Obama. The Churchill grandchildren regularly come by to appreciate the man they called Winnie. Winston Churchill wrote not only because he loved to, but...
Churchill wrote to make a living. He was a writer first and foremost, and his Nobel Prize was for literature, not for, like you would think, a peace prize. It was for his writing. It was for the Second World War. So he used the language magnificently.
It was Churchill who first used the expression, Iron Curtain.
From Stettin in the Baltic to Trieste in the Adriatic, an iron curtain has descended across the continent.
There is a first edition here of every book that Churchill wrote. And that would be the first book that he wrote, The Story of the Malakand Field Force, which was his famous green covers. That's the Churchill coat of arms. He wrote about his childhood, his early years in Sandhurst. Would you like to see the most valuable Churchill book in the world?
Of course.
In the early years of the century, Churchill was a young MP. He was still in his 20s. And it's still debatable how this came to be printed. Whether Churchill actually paid to have it produced, possibly. But it was done very cheaply. Some of his speeches were collected on a very particular subject for free trade. This is an original copy. There are copies that have been made from these because there are so few of them. But this book is in excess of $100,000. And there is not another one on the market.
While writing was Churchill's first love, he was a man of many hobbies.
He dearly loved painting. It was his method of relaxation. He painted hundreds and hundreds of canvases, and he never sold the painting by choice. He only gave them away or kept them.
And he was a bricklayer, too, wasn't he?
Bricklaying was one of his hobbies. Painting was the other.
Somehow you don't think of Churchill as somebody who would like to work with his hands in that way.
No. Well, his third hobby was drinking champagne.
And regardless of how Churchill spent his time, he always did so with style.
He had a sense of fashion, though. I mean, he liked to be seen in the vest and the
And that tie you're wearing, he loved that yes. bow tie. Did he give that to you?
Yes, he did. No, actually, when I saw this tie in a catalog, I said, that looks like Winston Churchill.
Winston Churchill was a larger-than-life personality with a pen to match. As Edward R. Murrow once said, he mobilized the English language and sent it into battle.
Let us, therefore, brace ourselves to our duties and so bear ourselves that if the British Empire and its Commonwealth last for 1,000 years, men will still say, this was their finest hour.